blended together to achieve a new dimension in sound impossible to obtain in a monaural recording.
Hi and welcome to this new sound comparison. Today we are going to compare the brand new Ultimate Ears Mega Blast against the Dokken Define. The Dokken Define is a bit bigger, as you can see. It also doesn't have as many features, so it's maybe not as waterproof. It's just splashproof and it's also an older speaker, but it offers better battery life and much better sound in my opinion. As you can see, yeah, the Mega Boom maybe looks a bit more stylish than the Dokken, but in my opinion it's about the sound. The Dokken goes for about $150, even $130 if you get lucky, and the UE Mega Blast goes for about $300 to $350, so it's quite a bit more expensive than the Dokken. So today we will see if it's really, I don't know, worth the extra price when it comes to sound quality. So now please put up your headphones, as this is a binaural microphone recording and they require headphones to sound good, and enjoy the sound comparison.
Your face, open it, it's warm and rain. Seek love before you. on the sidewalks.
Sidewalks.
Rolling down the avenue.
Avenues.
Sitting outside in cafes.
Cafes.
We were looking for the muse.
For the muse.
Well, I was locked in by the system. Freedom is a rule.
So now we are done with this comparison, and I think that this comparison again clearly shows that Ultimate Ear speakers are not good for personal or serious music listening. You could hear that the Dock and Defiant sounded better in any regard, and it's about half or even less than the price of the UE. So you could hear it sounded better on low levels, it sounded better on normal levels, it even sounded better on high levels, and it even sounded better on max volume. So there really is no need to buy the Ultimate Ears Mega Blast for serious music listening. You could hear on high levels and on max volume especially, the Ultimate Ears might have been 1 or 2 decibels louder, but that's not because it's a better speaker, that's just because they applied a simple trick to it. They just removed all of the bass, so you could hear there were basically, I don't know, no bass kicks anymore. remaining with the Ultimate Ears, and they just pushed the mids very far. I don't know, with a speaker of this size, it's of course impossible to reach a bass output of 100 decibels with the small transducers inside of the speaker, but if you just push the mids to the maximum, it is super easy to achieve 100 decibels of volume output, even with, I don't know, 2 5 centimeter drivers. So that's why all of the people are impressed by it. They think, wow, it's so loud and so crisp sounding, no distortion. Yeah, of course, because it doesn't have bass anymore. They just push the mids to the maximum, and that's very easy. I mean, you can do this with any cheap speaker and it will sound loud, but it's actually about the sound quality which comes out of the speaker. And the Dokken remains much better sounding, still keeping bass while only being about 1 or 2 decibels softer than the UE, so that's definitely a win for me. Also, on normal levels, you could hear there pretty much was no competition between those two. The Dokken had deeper bass, especially with acoustic music. It got very embarrassing for the Ultimate Ear speaker. You could hear the entire, rhythm of the track was missing. I mean, of course, the vocals, again, they were very loud, but you could also hear that the bass was super soft, so there was no relation between those two. The bass was much softer than the treble and the mids, and that just shows that the Ultimate Ears is a speaker which is meant for, impressing people, in air quotes, because it actually doesn't impress me, but to impress other people who are, not really into speakers in the first glance, because they think, wow, it's so loud. It's actually not loud, it's really not that good sounding, so you could hear again, mids and treble were much louder than the bass. The bass of the Dokken also, again, was in a much better relation to the mids, so everything was equally loud and equally played. Also, the bass of the Dokken reached much deeper than the UE. You could hear the bass kicks, which were very sophisticated in the background with acoustic music, were played much nicer with the Dokken, while they were almost missing with the Ultimate Ears. You could also hear with a track called It Once Was My Life by Van Morrison, that the, talking in the beginning was totally off sounding with the Ultimate Ears. I don't know what tuning they applied there or what kind of DSP technology they used, but it sounded nothing like a real recording. The Dokken really played them seriously, as if you were in the room, at least compared to the Ultimate Ears, or let's call it the UE. Also, treble was missing resolution, so really there's nothing special about the Ultimate Ear speaker when it comes to sound. Of course, I can get that people are saying, wow, it has nice features. I totally agree on that. I mean, it's loud, and it even, of course, one good thing about the UE, it really improved over the previous generation. So on max volume, it doesn't have this kind of weird compression and echo going on, although still, it had it a little bit. I tried it with the very extreme tracks, especially the first one, had a lot of kind of, hi-hats in it, and a lot of fast bass kicks, and you could still hear this kind of slight compression thing, treble echo going on. You could hear it wasn't quite precise, it was already playing the next note while the other one was still there, so it sounded pretty much very hollow and very echoey, while the Dokken again sounded much better on max volume, but still the UE does this kind of compression thing and software improvement thing much better than the previous UE Megaboom, although still it's far from perfect sounding on max volume. Just wanted to admit this because it got better, but it still isn't good. And of course, also with modern music, you could hear the gap between the Dokken and the Ultimate Ears wasn't as big as with acoustic stuff, but you could still hear, there was pretty much, again, almost no comparison. The Dokken played the track more mature bass kick, again, nicer, more smooth sounding mids, and the Ultimate Ears just sounded hollow, and just something about the sound wasn't right. It doesn't sound like a good high quality $300 speaker to you. It just sounds like some speaker. It doesn't really sound exceptional or good in any way, especially compared to the Dokken. And again, coming back to the earlier topic, I can get that people say that the features are nice. I totally agree on that. I mean, it looks good, it's high quality, it's super durable, it's waterproof, but those features are additional and they are not essential for a speaker. People shouldn't buy people shouldn't make their purchase decision of a speaker just based on features. You can just go in the store and buy any speaker because almost all of them are waterproof, but you should really think about the sound when considering to buy a speaker, because this is what a speaker is meant for, and not for being, thrown around against the wall or something and then surviving it. That's not what a speaker is about. You can buy a rock if you want to do this, but not a speaker. So yeah, many people actually confuse this, and for me, A speaker just is a good package if it, first of all, sounds good and then also offers nice additional features. And the UE only offers one of them, or one of those aspects, which are the nice features and sadly not the sound, which is of course the primary function of a speaker. And as it really fails in that category, I cannot recommend it. Maybe if you really are looking for a speaker, you can throw around everywhere and blast music on max volume and then, I don't know, hurt your ears or something. Just get the UE, otherwise go with a Dokken or with a FIFA Helsinki or something, because there are many other and better choices. Please don't hate on me in the comments if you have a UE and you are satisfied, it's just fine. I'm not saying your speaker is trash or something, but I'm just trying to recommend the right speaker for the people who are looking to buy one and watching this video right now. So if you enjoyed this video, despite my small rant on UE, you can leave a like on this video or subscribe to the channel to see more of this kind of stuff. Until then, have a great time and bye bye!